coming to the last few positions of the probes in the heart, but I have skipped apical for 3-chamber and 2-chamber view. They will be similar to your plaques view, so I will not be discussing them in more detail. Just inverted position of the plaques view, but this is the subcostal view. In subcostal view, the probe will be looking at the base of the heart, and it will be similar to the apical 4-chamber view, but with more precision towards the RA and LA, more in the RA and LA. If you still increase the cranial angulation or the caudal angulation, you can see that the IVC being opening into the RA. It will be seen in the next view. Okay, so here you can see that RA, LA and RV and LV. Most of the time the RA, LV is, RV is seen, and the IAS is very beautifully seen. The IAS and the perimembranous septum, which is in between the tricuspid valve and the mitral valve, the IAS part of the membranous septum will be seen very much well. So this is the position for congenital heart disease assessment also, because you start from the IVC, RA, RV, then LLV. And also in emergency situations also, this is the position where you will be seeing the IVC dilatation, the response to respiration and all. And this is what I told, when you just angulate the probe more cranially, you will be looking at the IVC being draining into the RA. So IVC measurement is done in the sneezing position or in the inspiration and expiration position, inspiratory collapse, expiratory collapse, all those are assessed in this one, and usually measurements are done in the end expiratory position to see for the IVC collapse and the dilatation because of the CCF. Most of the positions are done from here. And this is the suprasternal view, the one of the notch positions, and you are seeing the right pulmonary artery, and the notch is on the arch is seen very well, being the left coronary, left subclavian vein and the right subclavian, and the left coronary artery and the right coronary artery being seen going away from the arch in this view. But what is very important for us in the suprasternal view is the arch and the descending aorta, because you can see here beautifully that this is the arch and the descending aorta, this is the RPA which is seen, these are the subclavian or the internal carotid arteries which are seen going away from the probe. But what we assess here is the descending aorta of the arch, because distal to the left subclavian artery is the usual coarctation of aorta which we see, and coarctation of aorta or interrupted aortic arch, all these are seen in this position. And if you can put the Doppler here, and if you can take the continuous pressure gradients, then you can assess the turbulence also, and color Doppler turbulence will be there, and across the Doppler you can be detecting the continuous pressure gradients. If it is more than 20 mm, 24 mm, then most probably your interventions may help to relieve the patient of the pressures which the LV is under. Thank you.